Hello students, we are going to study what? Uniform and non-uniform motion. We have studied about motion in our previous class, isn't it? Now we are characterizing it in what? Uniform and non-uniform motion. So what is a uniform motion? Okay, so it means what? Equal distance covered in equal time. Suppose you have to cover how much? 10 kilometers. Okay. If you are covering 2 kilometer, 2 kilometer, 2 kilometer, 2 kilometer, okay, you are covering this 2 kilometer in suppose half an hour, okay, in 30 minutes. Again 2 kilometer you are covering in 30 minutes. Again 30 minutes. Again 30 minutes. Again 30 minutes. So total you have taken 1 hour, 2.5 hours. Okay. 2 hours, 30 minutes. Okay. To cover this how much? 10 kilometers. Okay. So 2 kilometers. You are taking 30 minutes, another 2 kilometer you are taking 30 minutes, another 2 kilometers. So totally you are covering how much? 10 kilometers, okay. So here you are seeing that equal distance you are covering in equal time. So this type of motion is known as what? A uniform motion. Uniform motion. Now, again I have taken that only 10 kilometers, okay. Suppose first 2 kilometers, okay, we are covering in 30 minutes. Next 2 kilometers, you are covering in 45 minutes, okay. Now, next 3 kilometers, you are covering in 45 minutes, okay, and next how much it has become? 2 plus 2, 4 plus 3, 7, so 3 more you have to, so 1 kilometer you are covering in 30 minutes, and again 2 kilometer you are covering in 45 minutes. You can see here, the distance and time is different. So here what you will say that this is what? A non-uniform motion. Okay. This can also be understood like if it is 10 kilometer divided in only 5, only 2 kilometer. Okay. Here you are taking 1 hour. Here you are taking 30 minutes. Here again you are taking 30 minutes. Again taking 1 hour. Okay. Again taking 1 hour. So you can see here the same distance is being covered in what? Different time. This is also a what? A non-uniform motion. Okay. Uniform motion will be when the distance, equal distance covered in same interval of time is known as uniform motion. Here, different distances covered in different time, okay, or the same distance is covered in different time, that is what? A non-uniform motion. Now, time and measurement. How is this time measured? Okay. So right now you all have watches, you see the time and say this is 4 o'clock, this is 3 o'clock in the evening, p.m. You are saying morning, a.m. you are saying, okay. But initially, this watch was not there, okay. People used to find out the time, how? By seeing the, what, the stars, okay. Changing the stars, how the stars used to change its position according to it, they used to take out the, what, time. Okay, later on other things also came which said about time, but they are also in Asia and in saying the time only, like sundial you can see in the Jantar Mantar in Delhi it is, okay, there this sundial is present, okay. In this what happened, according to the shadow, the time is said that yes, what the time is, how the, according the length of the shadow goes on decreasing, okay, it says about the time. Actually a plate has been fixed and its shadow falls on the other surface, and what happens, the shadow of this plate says about the time at that the present time, okay. If the shadow goes on decreasing, the time also goes on what changing, and it tells the change in the length of the shadow tells about the time. Sorry. Now sand clock, this is also a simple thing. In sand clock, what happens in this, you can see what sand is filled, okay, and this sand moves down, okay. So the duration it takes, actually the sand takes particular time to go into this chamber, okay. So the duration what the time is taking in order to get it filled over here, how much it has been filled, okay, and it tells about what the time at that present time which anyone wants to calculate. Next is the water clock. This is also like this only, okay. In this actually what happened, water is filled, okay, and here a container is kept, okay. This is also an apparatus only, okay, and in this what happens, water is filled. This water is allowed to fall down in this container. So it takes certain time to fall, okay, and that time which it is taking to fill this much or this much or this much, okay, this tells about the time changing taking place. Simple pendulum, this all this you see it right now also, it consists of what, a bob, this is known as bob, okay. So in this what happens, this bob, it can move, swing, isn't it, it can oscillate, and one oscillation, if it is here, go from here left to right, it goes and then comes to its own position. The time period it is taking to oscillate, okay, is same every time. So this also tells about what the timings, or if one wants to take out the time, it can be taken out. This is how the time is measured. Okay, so this is all for today. Good day. Take care.